Before we begin, the Protos X Ethernet IP bus coupler will only work with an implicit Ethernet IP client. You will need to install the latest version of the Protos X configuration software. Then you will need to connect a powered Protos X system to your PC using this cable. Open up the configuration software, select Tools, and then Connect. Now you should see a full listing of the modules you have connected. To set up the IP address of this adapter, select Tools, and then the coupler configuration. Enter in your IP address, and then you will see the resultant DIP switch settings that you will need to apply to your bus coupler. Make the changes to your DIP switches, and then select OK. You will then be asked to reboot the coupler. Select OK. Here will be the assembly instance information you will need to set up your client. Notice that the top is listed in bytes, but the format data is in 16-bit words. By selecting the plus sign here, you can see that the input word 1 and the input word 2 are mapped to the coupler. Same with the first two output words. If you continue down the tree of modules, it will show which words are mapped to each module. For the detailed purpose of each word, please consult the Protos X manual. Now let's take this assembly instance data and apply it to a productivity CPU. Open up your project, open up the hardware configuration, and then select the Ethernet IP tab. Drag the generic client into the gray area. Now you can place an individual tag for each of these elements, or you can check this box, Use Structure. This will create a structure of tags that contains all of these elements. I'm going to select the Use Structure and give it the following name. Now I'm going to give the device a name. Type in the IP address that we configured in the coupler configuration. Now the TCP port number for the Protos X coupler will always be 44818. Click on the green cross and select Add I/O Messaging. These tags will also be part of the original structure created above. This tag in particular will enable the reads and writes at the RPI that we select for each. Now here you will see that there are three tabs. Let's start with the input data block. From this information, we see that the assembly instance should be 101. The data array data type must match the data size of the input data block. Now from the information that we see here, we see that the data blocks are in 16-bit words, and there are 27 of them in total. So we need to create a data array of 16-bit type that has at least 27 columns. So type in the name of the data block you want to create, and when you try to select the number of elements, you will then be asked to create this array. Select the data type as 16-bit unsigned, and increase the number of columns to 27. Select OK, and then increase the number of elements to 27. Now select the Output tab. The assembly instance is 102, and I'm going to name my output data array as the following, and when I select the number of elements, I'll be asked to create the array. Change the data type once again to 16-bit unsigned, and the column size should also be 27. Click OK, change the number of elements to be 27. Now to set up the configuration word, enter the assembly instance of 100. I'm going to enter in the following data array, and when I click on the number of elements, this dialog will show up. Change the data type to 16-bit unsigned, and the columns can remain as 1. Select OK, and then the number of elements can remain as 0. When we select OK here, we will be completing the structure for this device. Now that the structure has been completed, let's open up the client and select Monitor. This will create a Data View tab to control and view all the tags associated with this setup. Now we just need to transfer this project to the CPU. With the project transferred and the PLC in run, let's open up the Data View to quickly test this setup. Select the Edit the Enable bit, and then select to send the edit. Now you should see the status indication of the connection. If you have any questions about the Protos X Field I/O system, please contact Automation Direct's free, award-winning support team during regular business hours. They will be happy to help. Click on this video to learn more about Automation Direct's many support options. Click here to learn more or see more videos on our many products, and be sure to click here to subscribe to our YouTube channel.